I mainly got started because my brother, he tried it through an after school program at the local club at the Utah Olympic Park. And I watched him for about 2 years and then I kind of wanted to try it. And then ironically, I started the same year as the Olympics when they came to Park City. So I remember watching the ski jumping event. Obviously it was only men's at the time. And just thinking that that was an awesome sport, and I tried it and I loved it, and here I am. It's really different than any other sport, just because we do the same thing over and over again, which you would think would get super boring, but there's always conditions changing and every hill is different, every location is different, and the exhilaration of going far and the pressure and flying a football field in the air, like not a lot of people can say that they do that. So I mean, it's unique and I love it. I mean, for me, I had been alpine skiing since the age of 2, so literally the hills you start off on are smaller than the little jumps on the side of the hill that I was hitting for years. And you just start with the super basics and your coaches just give you all the confidence, and they won't send you to a bigger jump until you're ready and you've mastered some of those basic things. And I still use those basic things every single day. And absolutely, being on stage at that convention, I remember I was backstage, I was 17 at the time, and like smoke machines, and I'm just like, oh my god, this is the scariest thing that's ever happened to me. Like, being at the top of world champs was pretty nerve-wracking, but at least I knew what I was doing. And reading a teleprompter to, I think there was like 8,000 or 9,000 people there, and just trying to remember how to speak English. Luckily, I am a little bit younger than the other girls on my team. I mean, they've paved the way tremendously to get women's ski jumping where it is today. And I'm lucky enough to only be 19 and hopefully have more Olympics ahead of me. Those older girls have just worked so hard. I mean, all you want to do is do the thing that you love, and here you have to deal with media and politics and all this whole other aspect of it that nobody really wants to deal with when you just want to concentrate on sport. So, you know, I thank them for all the hard work that they've done for me and for the girls behind us, because we are really the veterans, being the first time that women's ski jumping will be included. I had a really devastating injury at the end of August, and had to have basically total knee reconstruction. I blew my ACL completely. I tore my MCL off the bone, and I had damaged 80% of my meniscus. So I have stitches on both sides of my meniscus and my knee, and it was pretty devastating. Anything from not being able to make the Olympic team to sponsors dropping me ran through my head. And I came back home and talked to doctors, and they looked me in the eye and told me that it was absolutely possible. So from that day on, I put my head down and just, I've been training hard since. So it's definitely a different path that I had. I'm trying to train for Sochi, and right now it's kind of back to square one of just making the team, where before I definitely wanted to win a medal. I kind of denied saying that, but it was a goal of mine, and now I just have to say that I'll be thankful if I can make the team. Let's see, I used to play soccer, and before the girls were named into Sochi, I was kind of losing hope with the sport. I mean, unfortunately, without the Olympics, you can't have sponsors, and you can't make money, and it's not all about money. It's of course about your passion, but to pursue something in a professional manner, you have to have those things. So throughout high school, I always kind of considered playing soccer, and right before we got named in, I was really considering going off to school and playing for soccer. But now with my knee injuries and being in the Olympics for our sport, I've kind of chosen ski jumping. It's a little bit more unique, just a little bit.